So tonight we get to hear Dan Tappan play, which is really cool. Dan's been coming in for a number of years. Every time Dan comes in here with a new song, it's like better than the last one. It's really making me sick. This is going to run out of good materials. I'm looking forward to this. We'll pass the hat here, and Dan said, you know what to do. Dan's got chickens and goats to feed. So be generous.
You didn't know how much hay costs.
It's not chicken feed, I'll tell you.
Yeah. So thanks, John. And thank you all for coming out. I really appreciate you making it, passing up a championship football game, driving out here in the rain. Not sure I'd have made it if I didn't have to be here. But it makes it a lot better to have an audience.
All things we can nurture.
Each act of compassion shows we're in it for the long haul. Potatoes in April, but again the fall. Potatoes in April, but again the fall. In April, and I was afraid it was kind of going to be obsolete after this fall, but because it's one line, but I guess I'll be able to keep doing it for a while. This one I wrote much more recently than that.
Have done.
actually haven't written all that many political songs except apparently recently.
There's just so much material.
Yeah, something like that. Stuff on my mind. Most of my songs are about other things. For example, songwriter's favorite topic, me. I'm sitting on a settee, but there's nothing on TV. And my iPhone won't connect, so there's no one I can call. I pick up my guitar and play a simple chord, then sit there staring at the wall. It's hard to write a song about first world problems. You end up sounding whiny, self-entitled like a jerk. I might be crouching in the dark when missiles miss their mark. But the toughest test I'm facing is the TiVo dinner work. I open the frigid air and wonder if there's something there to ease that peckish load. When lunch and dinner time, although it's full of dishes, nothing satisfies my itches. I sit at the piano, but no verses come to mind. It's hard to write a song about first world problems. You always sound so petty, trying to work the referee. I might have traded my last cent for a bowl of rice and lentil, but instead I have to choose between the Gouda and the Brie. Wah-da-da-da, wah-da-da-da, wah-da-da-da-da, wah-da-da. Job is kind of boring. I'd rather still be snoring. I strum a little mandolin, but get no inspiration. It's hard to write a song about first world problems. Put down on paper they're trivial and trite. I might be smothering every day, picking crops from meager pay. Instead, I'm here complaining about my sorry plight. Wa-da-da-da-da, wa-da-da-da, wa-da-da-da, wa-da-da-da. It's not a favorite topic, it's not a topic that I actually have trouble writing songs on, which is the failed relationship song, which is kind of supposed to be the song that is staple. But the problem is that my wife and I we just celebrated our 35th anniversary last fall, so I don't have a whole lot of material to draw on there. So when I kind of have to write a song, I occasionally try to write one just to get the practice in. This was one that I had to write as homework for a songwriting. Summer sun upon the stone warms the roots within. Winter ice expands the crack as harshly blows the wind. So nature reaches out her hand. Year on year of patient toil slowly grinds the cliff to sand, turns it into soil. is the wind that curves the mountain, the rain that washes softly, tears houses from the hill. The hand that touches gently is the hand that writes the letter, the hand that wields the blade. Sculptor caresses stone, feels the form within, holds her chisel, makes a mark, hammer drives it in. Working as the room grows dark, shaping stone with hand and mind, day by day removes the rock, leaves the soul behind. And the wind that bends the barley is the wind that curves the mountain, the rain that washes softly tears houses from the hill. The hand that touches gently is the that writes the letter, the hand that wields the blade to make the kill. Pain's the knife that carves your life, sorrow holds the healing. Denial hides the holes, shadows are revealing. Letter lying by the door, floral scented, etched in black. Twilight creeps across the floor. I know you aren't coming back. And the wind that bends the barley is the wind that curves the mountain, the rain that washes softly tears houses from the hill. The hand that touches gently is the hand that writes the letter, the hand that wields the blade to make the kill. The hand that wields the blade to make the kill. There's one song I just tabled out that I think is very my wheelhouse. I once did a round, a songwriter's round, one of those things, and after I'd done about five songs, I suddenly realized that every one of them had been about death. So here's one. Annie's eyes are on the ocean, from her tower on the hill. She's watching for a distant motion, past the endless swell and billow. Moonlight marks the water, but Annie's watching still. Bid farewell to Annie on the hill. Give farewell to Annie on the hill. Toby's thoughts are on the ocean, from is stationed by the dome. He's watching with a blind devotion, waits for footsteps on the floor, but silence marks the meeting Toby's waiting for. Bid farewell to Toby by the door. Bid farewell to Toby by the door. Dreamed of glory, joined the cause, boarded ship for distant lands, left my family, farm, and friends. Sir, they would understand, but there's a field beyond the ocean where a sea of poppies grow. Sunlight brews a mystic potion, soothes the souls that rest below, and nothing mars their beauty but markers row on row. Bid farewell to we who rest below. Bid farewell to we who rest below. Dreamed of glory, joined the cause, boarded ship for distant lands, left my family, farm, and friends, so they'd understand. But moonlight marks the water, and Annie's watching still. Bid farewell to Annie.
Speak in depth. This is an old English ballad that I wrote a few months ago. I was reading a book of short stories by Neil Gaiman, and one of them grabbed me and said, "This has to be an old English ballad." The thing about the old ballads is, you know, somebody's going to die. You don't know who for sure, you don't know how many, but somebody's not going to make it out the end. And the other thing, this is a word of advice, if you ever find yourself, wake up and find yourself a cabin boy in an old English ballad, get off the ship as soon as possible, because it's not going to end well for you. I sat by the dock in the chill evening. A woman approached me, her manner unnerving, her tone it was flat, her face it was old. The words she spoke made my blood cold. As I set the captain, she told this story to me. My son was a sailor, dreamt of the sea, and all his ambitions confided in me. To return as a captain of wealth and renown, buy me a house at the center of town. But feared in my heart he would follow his father and all of those sailors, one after another, who left with the tide but never returned from the sea.
They told me his ship by storm waves was tossed, and here all the sailors aboard her were lost. Told me my son with his shipmates was drowned, swept in the ocean, his body not found. Insurance paid off for ship and the cargo, but not for the sailors who'd given their lives. Though they labored to save her before she was claimed by the sea. But the mate of the vessel returned from the barrage, friend of my husband's, but better of mine, told me a tale of a boat on the ocean. It shipwrecked sailors in days of starvation. In the end, they drew lots so some could survive. My son was the smallest, barely alive. They picked his bones clean, they buried their crime in the sea. Well, he thought I should know, he brought me this token I wear on my neck. Though my heart's broken, they'd all sworn an oath. He told me their secret, the one I revealed to him. Cut his heart deeper, what he'd done to his son. He could not endure, he turned, he left me. He walked to the shore, put stones in his pockets, and waded out into the sea. She showed me the bone, she wore at her throat, vanished in shadow, and so the spell broke. I sat alone in the chill of the evening, stared at the ocean, and felt my heart beating, and pondered her story and all who work on the sea. End with this one, which is very recent. And I'm dedicating this to everybody who was marching yesterday and everybody who will be marching in the future. Darkest days of winter, at the waning of the year, in the stillness of the cold, comes a message soft but clear. Not a gathering of angels or a bugle's brazen blare, but a whisper in the stillness, a glimmer in the dream, a promise for tomorrow. The sun will reappear, a promise for tomorrow. The sun will reappear. Though you might miss the signal of the lifting of the dark, a baby's laugh, a tender touch, a meeting in the park. The lighting of the darkness is the lifting of a stone, a message in the morning,
not walk alone. We do not walk alone. When hazy days of grayness feel like cotton to the soul, when life's constant disappointments make a mockery of toil, though days stretch on forever and nights are longer still, and the tunnel's twists and turnings seem an endless path until there comes a morning sunrise to free the light and will. There comes a morning sunrise to free the light and will. Though you might miss the signal of the lifting of the dark, a baby's laugh, a tender touch, a meeting in the park, the lighting of the darkness is the lifting of a stone, a message in the morning. We do not walk alone. We do not walk alone. The fight against injustice wears your spirit down. If you know your destination, but a path cannot be found, standing by the barricades, take a look around at the crowd of kindred spirits who stand on common ground. Voices raised together in a rare and holy sound. Voices raised together in a rare and holy sound. Though you might miss the signal of the lift of the dark, a baby's laugh, a tender touch, a meeting in the park, the lighting of the darkness is the lifting of a stone, a message in the morning. We do not walk alone. There's a message in the morning. We do not walk alone. We do not walk alone.
Okay. Setlist. I was playing for a different encore. But then Eugene Cernan died, the last man to walk on the moon. And some years ago, as you probably know, Neil Armstrong, the first man to walk on the moon, died. And shortly after that, I was reading the stories, and I read one story that told how when William Safire was writing the speech for Nixon to give after the moon landing, he actually wrote two speeches. One for if the landing was successful, one for if it was failed. And I got this image of Neil standing on the moon, looking around the scenery, looking back at the earth, this song came out, and I called it Home. In Ohio,
The moon's a brilliant beacon in the sky. Over hills into valleys, it casts a silver glow. A lantern laying light along the road to guide a weary traveler to his home in Ohio. Stars are distant candles in the night. Opalescent sparkles, mysteries of light, burning in the dome of summer sky. Crystallize the beauty of July in Ohio. Hills are rounded, worn by wind and snow. Fences line the pastures, orchards stand in rows. Cardinal sings a cheery tune. Steeples in the distance mark a town. There is you.